What's up? We're good. Thank you for having us over at your place.
Sure, no problem.
So since we're here, we're out to catch up with you a bit to get you know better, to get to know you some more.
Okay.
So we have a few questions lang. So let me start with, if you could describe your day today in a song, what would it be?
The Lazy Song. Bruno Mars.
Perfect. If your covers could have a label, what would it say?
Label?
Young are you?
19 years old.
Can a day go by without you singing a song or humming a tune?
No.
How did your love for music start?
When I was a kid, I grew up hearing my parents sing because they're professional singers, so that's how I started to love music.
Oh, so what genre do they sing?
They sing classical ballads. I'm the opposite.
Is that their profession?
Yes.
Background, how they started and how they influenced you, did they teach you or something?
Well, my parents are classically trained and they're also voice talent, so I basically grew up in the studio watching them do recording, so that's how I kind of picked up the whole music thing.
That's why you're kind of into some older songs.
Yes, definitely.
So how many instruments can you play?
I can play band instruments. I can play the guitar, the ukulele, the bass, the piano, and the drums.
Surely they've been a huge influence, but what made you really love music?
I think it would be some of my musical influences, like Lana Del Rey, Lord, and Beyonce, Lady Gaga.
Has it always been your dream to become a singer or a performer?
Yes, I've always loved performing and it's something that I wish to do for the rest of my life.
What do you consider are your career highlights?
Meeting my fans, performing in YouTube Fan Fest, and performing in PICC.
We have a little visitor here. You can go with me.
Now Gaston is 7 months old. He's an English bulldog. Gaston, sit, 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 sit.
How do you usually bond?
We used to walk a lot, but since he's a bulldog, he became lazy. So we just, you know, he chills with me in my room. He just lies down.
How long do you usually spend time together? I mean,
I'm pretty busy lately, so about like 1 to 2 hours a day.
Well, let's get moving with Gaston then. So still about your career highlights, can you name other few? Do you have other things that you want to share about that?
My career highlights, I think, what else? Since I'm a YouTuber, I did a campaign last year to reach 100,000 subscribers. And I got to reach that goal in a span of 2 months with my fans, of course. So that's basically one of my biggest highlights. Who would have thought that we could reach 100,000 subscribers in 2 months? So it's amazing. Yeah.
Just a little backtrack. How is it like growing up in a musical family? Is there any pressure there?
No, because my parents have been very supportive with what kind of music I want to sing. It's fun because especially when we hang out as a family, we get to sing together, we get to jam, blend together. So it's fun. There's no pressure at all.
How old did you start performing? As in a formal performance in front of the crowd?
Remember when exactly? I think around 7. I did a lot of school stuff and I sang in church also. Performances on stage.
How about your first gig? Can you tell us something about that?
My first gig was in Freedom Bar, and that was for Ukulele Manila. It was a very unexpected gig because I just met the organizers a couple hours before the gig, and they invited me to sing. So that was my first. I was around, I think, 12, and I was the youngest in the room. So yeah,
that was pretty random. Can you sing to us the song that you performed on your first gig?
Who knows how long I loved you? You know I love you.
first ever cover?
My first ever cover. Husband said she's in the class 18, stuck in her daydream, and this way since 18, but lately this seems.
So the first video that you uploaded is really your first cover.
Yeah.
You haven't tried anything.
No.
See? Your top three favorite covers.
Top three favorite covers. What a Wonderful World and Can't Help Falling in Love with You. That's a mashup. Mm-hmm. And then Close to You by The Carpenters and ILYSD by The
Majority are quite classics.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Have you ever had an international gig?
Yes, I actually performed around 6 times in New York.
6 times?
Yeah.
Can you sing to us the first song that you performed in NYC?
Someday, and I'm off the road, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you. And the way you look tonight
makes our heart melt. Can you tell us about the entire, how would you sum up the entire 6 times that you've been in the Big Apple?
Very fun, and a lot of people, especially in the States, are very appreciative of your art. So it's a very memorable experience, for sure.
But we're quite curious, what makes your works or your covers unique?
I think besides the fact that I sing a lot of classic songs, which is something that I believe not a lot of people do these days, especially my age, I think it would be the aesthetic of my videos that is most appealing to most of my viewers, because I want my videos to look like a moving Instagram picture, if that makes sense. So that's one thing that kind of like draws people to watch my videos.
Well, if you had to meet one singer whose songs you've covered, who would it be and what would you tell that person?
If I were to meet one person
whose song you've had me covered?
I would want to meet, they're not complete na, but probably the Beatles, Paul McCartney.
thought you might say that. What would you tell them?
I would tell them that I love their music and I'm a big fan and I want to cry.
Sing the song that best describes you as a person.
Best describes me as a person. Beautiful by Christina Aguilera.
Memes.
Eight.
Now that you mentioned that, can you share your top 5 favorite memes? Can you imitate them?
That's one. Lovesick Blues, and so far it's been doing really well.
What were the feedback that you received after doing the cover?
I think a lot of people were surprised because they weren't expecting me to cover a song that's a meme. But yeah, a lot of people said that I did a pretty good job in doing my own version of the song. So,
since we heard it, you're also into dancing.
Yes. So I just started doing workshops with the A team this week. last Tuesday was my, oh no, yesterday was my first day. And yeah, I've been working with Coach Arda and the rest of the team, and it's been really fun so far. It's my second time dancing with them palang. I took their demo classes, and it's been really amazing, really fruitful, really tiring, but super worth it. And yeah, decided to get in touch again with my dancing roots since I used to dance before, but then I stopped. So it's good to be dancing again.
Because you mentioned dancing, so of course you have to tell us a little background about your dancing roots.
Oh, okay. So besides singing, a lot of people don't know that I also dance, especially before in school. I was very active in the dance club and dance activities. I would do choreo a lot. I was the dance club president. so yeah, it's basically something that I love doing also besides singing, but not a lot of people know that yet. So that's why I'm training with A-Team.
Have you ever done a dance cover?
Not yet, but I'm planning.
Before we get into some intimate place of yours. Okay, first question. What is your guilty pleasure?
Stick off.
Pet peeve?
Wet bathroom floors.
Go-to shower song?
Go-to shower song. Never enough.
Go-to karaoke song?
Go-to karaoke. My heart will go on.
If you'd be given a chance to be a Disney princess, who would you be and why?
Brave. Because I love how fierce and independent she is as a woman.
Favorite Disney song?
A Girl Worth Fighting For from Mulan.
What is your spirit animal?
Spirit animal. A bulldog.
First original song or composition that you made?
I was around 3 years old. I did this song called Titi Lala. It means I love you, Grandpa.
Oh.
It was for my Lolo.
Cute. Where would you normally go rather if you'd like to write a song?
My room.
Yeah. Describe yourself using a color.
A color? Gray.
What is one thing that is seemingly useless but is actually useful to your everyday life?
A pick. A guitar pick.
Last question. If your mom was an instrument, what would she be?
A piano.
Second to the last, rather. How about your dad?
He would be a cello.
Your brother?
A ukulele.
Last, Gaston.
He would be a trumpet.
Okay, let's go with it.
Hey! Welcome to my humble home. So these are my ukuleles. This is my family. So this is my latest ukulele. This is the last one that I received. And her name is Adela. This was sent to me from China. And then this one is Finn. He's pretty special to me because this is my first ukulele Manila uke. And then here I have Renee, of course, which is named after me, because this is my signature ukulele. It was custom made for me, but I designed it. This was a gift for me for my 16th birthday, and this is what I used when I performed. So this is a really cool. Then this is Bobby. This was originally my brother's, but then I ended up having it instead. This is Bobby. And then this one is from Korea. I don't have a name for him yet, but I really love how this sounds. And then lastly, this is my first ever ukulele. The first ever ukulele I ever owned. Her name is Ellie.
I'm just curious, how do you go about in naming your ukulele?
It depends. Either I just like the name or I associate it with the situation I was in when I bought them. So yeah, it depends.
And you also see something there? Last
oh, one. Yeah, of course. This is my big baby. This is my only guitar. This is what I use to perform. And her name is Savannah, and she is an Ovation Celebrity Edition Turtleback guitar.
Would you consider naming your a musical instrument of yours to Gaston?
No, that would be awkward.
Well, if Gaston would give you a name, what do you think would it be?
Ooh.
Would you agree to not see Gaston for a month in exchange for a 24-hour bonding with your favorite international star?
No.
We thought so. Well, another random question. If your life story would be featured in MMK, what would your title be?
Music and Beyond.
Interesting. You probably sit here and continue.
Okay.
Sure. Well, in addition to that, which celebrity would you like to portray your character?
I would like to portray my character?
Yeah.
Me.
Of course. We heard about your hyper-adrenalism. We saw your tweet about that. Can you tell us? I mean, it's something that we saw all your tweets and it's really inspiring.
Okay, so my doctor diagnosed me with hyperadrenalism. It means that my heartbeat is beating a lot faster than normal, even when I'm not doing anything. But the thing about this case is it can go away, so that's what I'm praying for. Because I'm very active, especially now, so I do pray that this goes away.
We also saw that you've been into boxing.
Yeah. I started taking classes in this boxing gym called Flyweight because one of my friends is an instructor there. Mm-hmm. So that's what made me go into boxing. And then sometimes I do boxing also in my home gym. It's really fun.
But we also noticed that you also love traveling. What was the first country that you visited?
My first country would be Singapore.
If you could return to one place or country, what would it be?
U.S. New York, for sure.
Worst traveling experience.
I think that was during our last trip to New York when we were supposed to board the plane at, I think, 12, and then we ended up boarding the plane at 7 p.m. because of some delay. So, yeah, that was
crazy. Best travel experience?
New York last September 2017, because that was the time when I got to perform a lot.
What's with New York? I mean, it seems that you really love it.
Yeah, because it's the first state that I've been to in the US, and my manager is there, and I also just fell in love with the place. I think I could see myself living there. It's basically like my second home.
Who's your travel buddy?
My mom.
What is one country you will never get tired of visiting again and again?
I think that would be the US. I haven't been to a lot of countries yet, so.
Well, what would be the country that you would want to visit?
Anywhere in Europe. Yeah.
One thing that you'd always bring during a trip?
My guitar and my ukulele.
Where do you go if you're feeling happy?
Happy. Anywhere.
When you're feeling sad?
My room.
What calms you when you're angry?
Music.
Describe your aesthetic in three words.
Moving Instagram picture.
Perfect. What are the things you consider when posting an Instagram photo?
I think it can be a little bit technical, but I really look at the coloring, the palette,
mm-hmm.
and how it can complement the previous photo that I posted, so it would look like a nice theme.
Rank the following: music, photography, dancing, acting, fashion, makeup. Which goes first?
Music.
Second.
Dancing.
Third.
Acting.
Mm-hmm.
Photography.
Mm-hmm.
Makeup.
Mm-hmm.
What's the last?
Fashion.
Random words. We just want to hear your thoughts. Fame.
I'll think what?
What are your thoughts about it?
Oh, okay. It's a nice thing to have, but it's also dangerous.
Underratedness.
Needs more light. Love.
Talent.
My thoughts about talent. I think that a lot of Filipinos have talent.
Vlogging.
Vlogging is something that everybody's doing today.
Covers.
Covers. It's a good way to show people your uniqueness and turning songs into your own.
The Beatles.
I think they're the best ever.
Last, OPM.
OPM is not dead.
Agreed. Let's go to the Kikay side of yours naman. What are your makeup must-haves?
Makeup must-haves. Haves. Eyelash curler. Mm-hmm. Cheek tint. Eyebrow pencil and lipstick.
How about fashion must-haves?
Denim shorts, a sweatshirt, white sneakers, and a cap.
What color dominates your closet?
Black and white.
You currently have 300,000 plus subscribers. How do you feel about that?
I feel very happy and very overwhelmed.
How was your journey like as a YouTuber?
It's been a roller coaster. There were rough times, but definitely a lot of happy times. And it really helped me grow, not just as a creator, but as a person.
Aside from singing, do you also consider focusing on your acting career?
Definitely.
Have you done any projects, any acting projects so far?
I've done, on TV, I've done a cameo for Born For You. Mm-hmm. That was Janelle and Elmo's teleserie. And I did a couple guest things in ASAP and Mix, but I haven't really done a lot of teleseries.
How was it like starring in one of Adober's Bakit Ka Single series? Walk us through the process.
Okay. It's been really fun. I was asked if I wanted to star in it. Mm-hmm. So the process, it wasn't really hard because like everybody from my co-stars, the crew, everyone was so warm and fun to be around. So I really did not feel any pressure.
What would be your dream role?
Dream role? I want to be a superhero.
What kind of superpowers do you dream of having?
I think the ability to control time, fly, and have fire and ice as my powers.
Cool. Yeah. In one of your Q&A videos, you've shared that you've taken up theater arts.
Yes.
And you took a break to pursue your career. What do you miss most about being in school?
What I miss most is, I think, just going to class. Mm-hmm. And walking around campus in the afternoon to get like a milkshake or to get waffles, because I study in UP, so it's very peaceful there, especially during the afternoon.
What is your greatest takeaway from the experience?
I guess just stay true to who you are, stay grounded, and don't let anybody bring you down.
Second to the last question, what do you think of the idea that music isn't something that you can really study?
It depends, because if you want to take music as a profession, you definitely have to study, but I don't think that you have to study in order to love music, because music is very universal and everybody has a freedom and a right to love music and pursue music no matter where you're from. So yeah.
So true. Last question. Say something about this statement. Back then my goal was to be Beyonce, but it's not anymore. I want to be Renee.
True. Well, yeah, I think that a lot of people idolize these people and they want to be like them, but the thing is, it's better to be the first you than to be a second someone else.
Well, that I guess wraps up our questions for you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.